when you are in me time, the principle of verse 3 is that while you are there, you've got to get rid of your bitterness. And God still has some of you in me time because you're still bitter. Okay, here it is. The principle of verse 3, you've got to learn how to remember those that rejected you. You remember in 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 11, when it was anointing time. David's daddy didn't even have him on the list. He said, I got all of these beautiful young men, these robust young men, but they wasn't the one. He rejected David, but now David says, I want the best for my daddy. Come here. Can you desire the best for those that wanted the worst for you? Can you talk good about those that talk bad about you? Can you bless those that curse you? Can you embrace those that's trying to put a dagger in your back? Come on, talk to me here. The problem some of us, the reason some of us are still in me time is because we have not released those that hurt us the most. And as long as you hold the grudge, as long as you hold the bitterness, you're going to put yourself in a holding pattern and you're going to die without the promise. Shake two or three hands and say, it's time to release some stuff. Come on, tell them like you mean it. Tell them, neighbor, it's time to release some stuff. Tell them. Come on, tell them like you mean it. This is helping somebody. Tell them it's time to release some stuff. They may never call you, but you pick up the phone. Sometimes the people you deal with may not be saved. So, but if you are the Christian, you've got to deal with them with a Christian attitude. I'm closing, but some of the greatest hurt that you can ever have can be in the church and the ones that's closest to you. But when you're in me time, you say what's going on is not about you, but it's about me. But then you need to see the text says now that there's a shift for your predestined position. When am I going to come out of this? Veal, what's the confirmation for me coming out? Here it is right here in verse 5. And the prophet Gad said unto David, abide not in the hole. Watch this. Number one, you need an elder for emancipation. This is where your pastor comes in. You've got to have a connection to your covering. That does not mean be on the phone with him. That does not mean be up in his face. But that means that when I have a connection with the man of God, he's my covering, and he'll tell me when my release day is coming. Is there anybody here thank God for your shepherds? Is there anybody here thank God? Okay, well, how do I know when there's a covering? Hold it. Let me give this to you and I'm done. Have you ever come to church and they were talking about one thing? You hadn't talked to anybody in the church, no servant leaders, nobody. And just all of a sudden, they start preaching your week. They start preaching what you've been going through the whole month. You haven't told anybody, but just all of a sudden, Pastor Joe and Pastor Williams have just started talking about everything that you've been going through. That's the Holy Ghost trying to let you know. Because of your connection, your man of God is telling you that a change is getting ready to come. Is there anybody in here believe that a change is getting ready to come?